Hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicles have always been seen as something of a science experiment, but Hyundai reckons it's now got the technology so well nailed that a car like the new NEXO is a viable mainstream alternative to the family SUV.
NEXO is part of an environmentally focused push for the Korean brand, which plans to introduce 38 new eco-friendly models by 2025. The small SUV combines a hydrogen fuel cell and lithium polymer batteries to power an electric motor that in turn drives the front wheels. It's a system that bypasses the lengthy charge times of battery electric vehicles and sees the NEXO emit nothing but water vapour from its tailpipe.
Despite the complicated workings under the bonnet, the experience from behind the steering wheel is one of absolute simplicity. It does seem to be that there's a lot of buttons on the dash and it is a bit of a high-tech instrument panel, but really, this is a very simple car to drive.
The steering is light and accurate and stability at highway speeds secure. There's very little noise to speak of too, the NEXO's cabin well finished and appreciably high-tech.
As well as demonstrating Hyundai's hydrogen technology, there's of course a number of autonomous features in the new NEXO, and we're pleased to report that they all work exactly as the brochure says they will. In fact, we reckon it's one of the most seamless autonomous packages we've yet to experience.
Hyundai's Level 4 hands-off autonomous systems allow the NEXO to pilot itself in freeway driving. The car can match speed and maintain lane position at speeds up to 150 kilometres an hour and is also capable of parking itself remotely without a driver at the wheel.
Our road drive in South Korea has been pretty boring for the most part. It has been a freeway drive with very few corners, very few bumpy roads, but the car has performed very well. Acceleration's quite strong, it's very, very quiet, and underfoot, it does get up and go rather well.
The NEXO will go on sale in Australia, but will mostly be sold into government fleets to trial the viability of the technology for general consumption. At this point, the only real disadvantage consumers may face being the lack of places to fill up and a pretty hefty list price.
We've spent quite a few hours driving the NEXO today and can tell you that it does indeed meet Hyundai's range claims. All we need now is to get the infrastructure in place to make hydrogen-powered cars like this a realistic alternative.